Hello everyone, welcome to our video lecture on Kepler's laws for planetary motion. Myself K.R. Biradar, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Let us start with the learning outcomes first. At the end of this session, students will be able to describe Kepler's laws for planetary motion. Introduction. Earth revolves around the sun in a definite orbit. This is a fact. We know Earth always revolves around the sun in a particular orbit. Likewise, the same way artificial satellites which are launched by us which revolve around the Earth in a definite orbit. So, the principles which are applied for Earth revolve around the sun and artificial satellites or man-made satellites revolve around the Earth are same. Kepler gave three most important laws in satellite communication theory. Those are called Kepler's laws for planetary motion. These are popularly known as Kepler's laws. Kepler's first law and its statement. It states that the path followed by planets around the sun will be an ellipse. Kepler's first law he stated the path followed by planets. Maybe Earth is a planet which revolve around the sun and it follows a definite path, that is ellipse. It follows elliptical path. We can see this diagram, figure 1a. It consists of a two focuses, F1 and F2. And there is an elliptical path. In the elliptical path, the planets will be revolving. The sun will be present at one of the focus. See this animation. The sun is at one focus, that is at F1. The earth is revolving around this sun, but it is taking a elliptical path. That states the Kepler's first law. Kepler's second law. That statement is Kepler's second law states that for a equal time intervals, the area covered by satellite will be same. You can see this animation. There are two parts. Here you can see shaded line. It is one day to travel. So it is taking the time to travel from A to B. And the same area will be covered in the another place, but time it takes is same. This can be explained with one figure. We shall see that in the next slide. Let us see illustration of Kepler's second law. See, there are two focus in this ellipse. So, sun is at one focus. So, planet is revolving in a definite orbit and it follows the elliptical path as per Kepler's first law. There are two areas will be covered here. One is area 1 and area 2. The time it takes to travel from P1 to P2, it is T. And here to cover area 2, the time it takes to travel from P3 to P4 is also T. When these two areas are equal, that is area 1 and area 2 are equal for a given time t. Third law, or Kepler's third law, the square of the time period of orbit is proportional to the cube of the mean distance between the two bodies. That means time period, we know, time period is a time taken to complete one orbit by the planet. Square of the time period or time taken is proportional to the cube of the mean distance between two bodies, that is also called the semi-major axis. Mathematically, it can be written as t square is proportional to a cube. Here, t is a time taken to complete one path, r that is time period, and a is a semi-major axis. T square is proportional to a cube. See this diagram. It consists of a sun at one focus. The planet is revolving and taking the elliptical path as per Kepler's first law, and time to complete one particular path is t, and the distance between this end and this end is called the major axis. Half of it, that is one of the end and its center, that is called the semi major axis, that is a. Here t square is proportional to a cube. T is the time taken and a is the semi major axis as shown in this diagram. But when you consider, that is semi major axis, this side also semi major axis, it becomes major axis. By removing now proportionality constant, because the t square is proportional to a cube, if I remove the proportionality constant, this becomes t square is equal to 4 pi square divided by mu into a cube, where t time period to complete one path, a is a semi-major axis, and the mu is the Kepler's coefficient. Same thing it defined here, but mu is Kepler's constant. Its value is 3.98004 into 10 to the power of 5 kilometer cube per second square. If the orbit is circular, then the radius of this circle is equal to semi-major axis A, r is equal to A. Therefore, t square now becomes equal to 4 pi square by mu into r cube. Wherever the A is there, that will be replaced by r. This is a total time period calculation formula. Let us see one example. Calculate the orbital period of the satellite moving in an elliptical orbit having Kepler's coefficient is 3.98866 into 10 to the power of 5 kilometer cube per second square and major axis of 50,000 kilometer. What he has given here? Kepler's coefficient, that is mu, 3.98866 into 10 to the power of 5, and major axis, that is 2a, he has given, that's equal to 50,000 kilometer. Pause the video, think and try to solve this problem. I think you might have solved this problem. Let us see the solution. What he has given? Mu he has given. Mu is equal to 3.98866 into 10 to the power of 5 kilometer cube per second square. Major axis he has given 2a is equal to 50,000 kilometer. Now if I calculate minor axis, major axis is 2a, minor axis is a. So if I take two other side, it becomes a equal to 25,000 kilometer. Now we have a formula, t square is equal to 4 pi square a cube by mu. If I substitute all the values, so t becomes equal to 39,344 seconds. I need to convert this one in terms of hour, minute and seconds. First you need to divide it by 60, that comes in minutes, and then again you need to divide it by 60, that comes in hours. So it comes around 10 hour 55 minutes and 44 seconds. These are the references I used to prepare the above PPT. Thank you.